So a couple of lectures ago, we started to discuss, just really at a high level, VBA and how Visual Basic for Applications is an object-oriented programming language. Now, object-oriented programming is a huge concept. We discussed it again, just kind of at a high level, but let's dig a bit deeper into this whole idea of objects, getting access to the object, and being able to communicate and manipulate those objects inside of Excel. So inside the Visual Basic Editor, let's make sure you have that open. I'm gonna resize my window here, just so I can see both the Excel window in the background and my Visual Basic Editor right here. Now we're gonna take advantage of the immediate panel or the immediate window. So let's make sure you have that open. Remember where to find that? And go to my view menu, and let's make sure you got the immediate window open. Just got a shortcut key of Control G. So the immediate window, kind of looking at its name, immediate. You can write code in the immediate window. You type it in, you hit your enter key, and immediately that code will run. So for our training purposes right here, we're going to use the immediate window to practice this idea of object-oriented programming. This way, we can write out a line of code, learn about the objects, get access to its properties or its methods, and see it run immediately without having to create a whole module and procedures and so on. All right. So I resized my windows because I want to see the Excel interface so I can see the objects that we're going to work with. And then I can write my code right here and see the changes kind of take effect and run immediately. So in my immediate window, let's talk a little bit about an object. So the first object that we saw earlier was kind of one of the top level high objects as you experience Excel. And this was the workbook object. So here I could say something like the active workbook. Oops, let's make sure I spell it right. Active workbook. Okay. So that's one of the objects that make up Excel, the workbook. Now, if we look really closely, this workbook, I just created a brand new one, a blank one, and it got a default name of book one, right? That's its name. Well, what if inside of your code, you want to know the name of your active workbook? Well, now that I've got reference to the active workbook, I can then start to communicate and manipulate that active workbook. Well, here, let's say something like active workbook. Great, that's the object you want. Now I want to get to its properties. In this case, I want to speak to its name property. So I'm going to bring in a dot, just active workbook dot. Placing the dot in there kind of carries to the next level within the hierarchy. Here, I now get a list of all of the properties and methods that make up that object. So here you can see there's different icons. The one that looks kind of like a little brick flying through the air, right? Little green thing. Those would be the methods. Those are things that the object, in this case, the workbook object, things that it can do, tasks it can perform. And then I've got what looks like a little finger pointing at a piece of paper. Those are the properties that make up this object. You can scroll through there. I would suggest pause the video for a moment, do a quick scroll through, take a look at what is in there. You've got loads of properties and methods. Some of them you're going to look at and be like, oh yeah, I know exactly what that is because I've done that inside the Excel interface. Some of them it's going to be perhaps not as clear just by the name that it was given. But take a moment, scroll through there. Now, I want to look for one specifically. If I scroll on through, I'm going to go to the N section. I've got one in there for name. I can give that a double click. That'll place it in there. Or as you become more and more familiar with writing your own VBA code, you're just going to do active workbook dot name. You're going to bang it all out on your keyboard. So however you do it, but let's get active workbook dot name. Now, we're in the immediate window. You write in your code, you hit the enter key, right away your code runs. But there's a key concept here that I want to introduce you to as you work with the immediate window. Right now, I'm getting access to an object and I'm going to get access to one of its properties. I'm trying to return the value of that property, in this case, the active workbook's name. Now, if I hit my enter key, it's going to throw up a warning, an error. Oh, compile error, invalid use of property. What's that all about? I got it right. We got the active workbook dot, we got the menu. I picked name from there. Well, this is something specific to the immediate window. If you're looking to return a value, you're looking to get something back from the system, in this case, the name of the active workbook, you have to start that line with a question mark. You are now questioning the application and getting a value back from it. And remember, this is specific to the immediate window. As we start creating procedures up inside of a module, you won't have to do this. It's specific to the immediate. And that's it. Question mark. Well, what do you want to know? In this case, get the active workbook and get its name. I'll hit my enter key. And look at that. We've now got the name of the active workbook. So again, objects. In this case, the active workbook. We then communicate with those objects through its properties and or methods. So let's take a quick peek. If I bring in active workbook again, dot, we just use name. That's a pretty common one. I need to know the name of the workbook. Perhaps I need to confirm that I'm in the active workbook. I'm in the workbook that I want to work with as my code runs. Okay. But there's loads of them here. Let's see, we've got active sheets. So I've got my active workbook dot, I'm going to grab active sheet, then I'll do a dot again. Oh, no little drop down. Hey, this is one of the things about working within the Visual Basic Editor. It's not the most robust system. It doesn't have all the bells and whistles. And IntelliSense, the little drop down menus that you get, don't always present themselves. But here, I've got access to an object, the active workbook, dot. I'm now going into a property of that active workbook called active sheet. This is actually an object. So at this point, I'm now on the active sheet object, which would be this guy right here. Well, now I bring in another dot. It didn't bring up the little dropdown for me, but I could bring in name. And remember, because I'm now returning, I'm getting something back from the system. What do I need to do? I need to start that line with a question mark. And if I hit my enter key, I can get back its name. Boop. There we go. So it's something you've all done this. Right, perhaps not writing it in VBA code, but this is something you've done inside the Excel interface. Oh, what's the name of the workbook? Oh, it's book one. What's the name of the sheet on that workbook? Oh, it's sheet one. But now we're just writing it out. Get to the object, now get to its properties and methods and communicate and or manipulate those objects. Let's try one more. So in both of these cases, we've been communicating with an object and getting something back from it. What if you want to change it? What if I want to change the name of the worksheet? What do I do then? Well, if I type in active workbook, I want to get to the active workbook object. I then want to get to the active sheet within that workbook. And then I want to get to the name property of that work, of that worksheet. Now I want to change its value. I want to change the actual name right here, all through code. Well, here I'm going to say space equal space. And inside of quotes, I'm going to put in a new value. So here I'll say weekly report. Now this time I'm not getting something back. I'm not going to ask the application a question to get something back, but I'm changing the value of that name property. So no question mark. I hit my enter key and I have now changed the name of that worksheet. Very cool. Very cool. Getting access to the object, get access to its properties and methods, and communicate and or manipulate those properties. Now let's just try one more. So this is all dealing with the active workbook, the active sheet within that workbook. Well, what if I want to change something within the range, a cell on the worksheet itself? Well, I could say active sheets. Now notice that I'm not using the active workbook object to then get access to the active sheet. That's just implied because the workbook is active in the background. It's there, it's available to me. It's going to assume that that's the one that I'm referencing. Now, so I'm going to say active sheet dot range. And now inside of parentheses here, I am going to bring in a specific cell reference, a specific range. I'm going to put this inside of quotes and I'm going to say A2. Now I'm going to the active sheet. I'm going to a specific range, in this case, A2. Now I want to change something about that range. In this case, I'm going to change its value. And I'm going to make this equal to hello world. And I'll wrap that inside of quotes. Now, once again, objects, you get into the object and you're then going to get into its properties and or methods. And you're either going to get something back or you're going to change something about it. In this case, we're getting down into the range object, specifically cell A2, and we're going to change its value. So I hit my enter key and I've now changed the value of cell A2. Hello world, done. Got the object, got a method within that object, the range, which is actually an object of itself, getting specific access to cell A2, and then the property of that cell and changing it to a value. So make sure you try this out. In the immediate window, type something in, hit your enter key, try out these lines that I've dropped in right here, and get a feel, at least again at a high level, get a feel of working with Excel objects in VBA and communicating with them and manipulating them. Try it out.